can I see you so merrily? Are they sparking and pie and toys? Happy girls and boys. What's the proper meaning behind this Christmas joy? We'll celebrate Jesus. I took her to the knees to me. It's the birthday of the one who makes the blind to see. He purchased my salvation. We're back on Calvary. I'm celebrating Jesus. I took Christmas means to me.
Welcome to the New Year's edition of Revelation Faithful. Hello, I am the Reverend Elaine Yavazak, and this is my 17th video for Revelation Faithbook. Today's message will be a recap of Revelation Faithbook's highlights in 2015 to ring in the new year. And so it was that while they were there, the days were accomplished that theirs should be delivered, and she brought forth her firstborn son, and wrapped him in swaddling clothes, and laid him in a manger. Hello, and welcome to Revelation Faithbook. I'm the Reverend Elaine Yavazak, and this is a kickstart to my group, Revelation Faithbook. And I've been out of work now for over 3 years, because of health reasons, and that was way back when I had a secular job and working for a bully boss. I was inspired to write a book entitled The Evil Within, A Lion's Den of Bullies, and it explains about my experience with having bully coworkers and a bully boss, and also bullying throughout school. And for a seminary assignment, I wrote my first book, which is entitled Till the End of Time. It's geared toward Christian young women. And I was going to write a third book, but I decided to make a video series on any hint of a four-letter word or anything nasty of or obscene of any kind. It will be disregarded entirely. It will be deleted and ignored. simple as that. Correction from a previous thing I said before. I said that I took meteorology. What I meant to say was I took introduction to weather. After I said that I'm not a motivational speaker, I'm not going to sit here, spew gummy bears out of my mouth, I'm not going to sugarcoat anything. And I said, because I might as well speak about the weather if I do that. So I meant to say introduction to weather, not meteorology. I never took meteorology in college. So that was an elective that I had to take to get my degree.
A conversation only we could make. You're breaking into my imagination. Whatever's in there, it's yours to take.
Watching my first video segment of Revelation Faith Book. I wish everyone a very blessed Christmas and a happy new year. Till next time, bye. I am going to start my segment on deception. This is the most dangerous form of evil. Believe it or not, because sometimes the tongue can be just like a sword. Whether or not the whole entire Bible was inspired by God, or parts of it that was written by man, the whole Bible was indeed inspired by God. I know a lot of people are not going to agree with me because I have heard this so many times. So what I have done, in other words, to describe what maybe an incomplete Bible is, I also refer to this as the Swiss cheese Bible. What I mean by the Swiss cheese Bible, let's say somebody's reading the Bible and they're not living a life that's pleasing to the Lord. In other words, I don't like this verse. I'm going to have difficulty with that. I don't like it. I will just ignore that verse. They read on and pinpoint which verses they like, which ones they don't like. And let's say they actually physically took a scissor and cut out all the verses that they didn't like. Like if they had to change something in their life that they don't want to change, I don't like that verse, I'm going to cut it out. Well, guess what? If you keep doing that, you will wind up with a Swiss cheese Bible. It's going to be a lot of holes in the Bible once you get done with it, if you keep doing that. Oh, here you go. This is going to be a message that's going to be not so easy to digest. What I mean by that is I'm going to be speaking of pastors who sugarcoat their sermons. It's going to sound sweet, you would think, because it's going to be a lot of talk about candy and sugar. So I saw this post on Facebook, and I thought this was extremely interesting. It describes exactly what I have been talking about. Sugar-coated sermons, and, you know, when I said I wasn't going to spew gummy bears out of my mouth, or I might as well be speaking about the weather. Well, I might as well do that right now to get it out of the way. It's bright sunshine outside here in Amityville, New York, but it's very, very cold, and there is still some leftover snow on the ground, and I hear for tomorrow, more snow is predicted. Not good. I am not a big fan of snow. I royally hate it. What can I say? So this particular post in Facebook that I came across is excellent. But unfortunately, many of you are not going to like this. So like I said earlier in my practice video, I said that there's going to be some things that people don't want to hear. And it's going to be a ton of it today. So is this going to be a red hot message? Be prepared. Whew. But like I said before, I'll be as gentle as I can. Okay, the heading is warning. Sugar-coated ear candy. Gospel is weakening saints. Now you may have noticed that I either don't have any notes in my hand, or like for my Christmas video, I had little index cards. Well, with this particular message, I feel like I need some shielding. Don't shoot the messenger. It's gonna be that kind of day. Okay, but we're gonna get through this. I know we are. Yes. Okay, shall we get started? And after conversion, they must experience change. Now that I know people have trouble with, change. They think, okay, I became saved. I said the sinner's prayer. I accepted the Lord in my heart. And then guess what they do after that? Absolutely nothing. They live a sinful life continuously. And they think everything is okay. But it says after conversion, they must experience change. Churches today are filled with people who seek instruction that is more in line with their lifestyles. Churches today are filled with people who seek instruction that is more in line with their lifestyle, their wishes, and their desires than with the good of their own soul. They serve up silly sermonettes to Christianettes in bassinets. I'll repeat that again. They serve up silly sermonettes to Christianettes in bassinets, meaning baby Christians. No repentance required? That's what some people think. They have a religious itch, and the pastor will scratch it by saying, "You're fine." That's what people want to hear. You're fine. Everything's wonderful. It sounds like a motivational speaker to me. Like I mentioned in a previous video, everything's okay. They will walk out feeling good about themselves. All the while, they're living in sin and thinking nothing of it. It sounds like a la-di-da, anything goes type of church. And may I say it? I don't know. Really, really liberal? That word scares me a little. When I hear liberal, ooh. When 90% of their problems come from their sinful lifestyles. Now, this isn't my words here. It's in this article. And I've been saying that about people's lifestyles. I've been bringing that up a lot. So this is in conjunction with what I have been saying before. With me so far? Should I continue? I'm going to continue. It's time to start a detox program. Detoxify. That's in. Get rid of it. I find this article just right in tune with what I've been saying all along. It's good to eat, but Swiss cheese shouldn't have anything to do with the Bible. Because look, holes. Incomplete piece of cheese. It's okay for a cheese to have holes in it, but not the Bible. It's wholesome. W-H-O-L-E, wholesome. Believe it in its entirety. Don't cut anything out of it because you don't like it. So, in case any of you are watching my video for the very first time, my big thing is what's called a Swiss cheese Bible, meaning people who pick and choose what verses they like or dislike. If they were to physically cut out some verses of the Bible in which they didn't like, well, you eventually have a Bible full of holes. Thus, the Swiss cheese Bible. And today, I will be speaking about 1 Timothy chapter 2, verse 12. There was somebody who emailed me in Facebook, and he was specifying in Bible verses, like this one here in particular, 1 Timothy 2, 12. It reads, I do not permit a woman to teach or to assume authority over a man. She must be quiet. What am I doing here on these videos? I shall explain further. Why, you might be wondering, am I doing these videos in the bathroom? Because I noticed the lighting is at its best in here. Anywhere else in our mobile home, it's not the best lighting, especially if the weather is poor. Yeah, that's the way it is. So I was very happy with the lighting in here, and it brings out clarity in my videos. It just makes me wonder why there are a lot of women in ministry in churches. What does God say about that? How he really feels about that? It seems to be very controversial with a lot of people, because I look at it this way. What I am doing, talking about Jesus, teaching, preaching, I feel the Lord is happy with what I'm doing. When you have Satan on the other hand, I think when I preach and teach, I believe Satan is cringing. I believe this is making Satan angry. I want to win souls to Christ, and I don't want to hear of anyone going to hell. I know there are a lot more people going there than there are going to heaven, and to imagine burning in hell and being tortured for all eternity, that is something I cannot digest. It just gives me the shakes, and imagining somebody going there or there already, it's just something I want to avoid. I want to avoid having somebody burn for all eternity. It's the worst thing you can think of. It is just worse. There's nothing worse than hell. And hell is a real place, whether some people want to believe it or not. It is just so terrible. And it was meant for the devil and his angels. It wasn't meant for us. Unfortunately, some people choose hell because they don't want to accept Christ in their lives. And there's nothing more heartbreaking than that. And I really, really believe I have been called to do this. Now, yes, there are ways I can tweak my videos, entitling it, okay, the Revelation Faith Book by the Reverend Elaine Yalvazak is only for women and children. I could put that on my videos, but what concerns me is if a man comes across my videos who isn't saved or doesn't know what direction to choose, well, my goal and focus is to avoid another soul from going to hell. If the person needs to hear the message, I will give it to them. And I feel I am doing the right thing. This is what God wants me to do. This is what I was called to do. And this is my sixth video for Revelation Faith Book, in which I will be reading the Easter story today. God påske, which means Happy Easter in Norwegian. Christos anesti, which means He is risen in Greek. Today I shall be reading from Luke 22 through 24, the easy to read version. Then Jesus took a cup of wine. He gave thanks to God for it and said, "Take this cup and give it to everyone here. I will never drink wine again until God's kingdom comes." Then he took some bread. And thanked God for it. He broke off some pieces, gave them to the apostles and said, "This bread is my body that I'm giving for you. Eat this to remember me." After supper, Jesus took the cup of wine and said, "This wine represents the new agreement from God to his people. It will begin when my blood is poured out for you." Jesus said, "But here on this table is the hand of one who will hand me over to my enemies. The Son of Man will do what God has planned, but it will be very bad for the ones who hands over the Son of Man to be killed." Then the apostles asked each other, "Which one of us would do that?" Of my sixth video of Revelation Faith Book. I was happy to read the Easter story to you today. And I wish everybody happy Palm Sunday, happy Easter, Gu Porska, and Christos Anesti.